Hi my dear friends, I'm very happy to meet you all in this video. Now we are going to see the subject business studies. So this is the first lesson we are going to study in business studies. What is this lesson is about is mainly this subject is dealing about business. First lesson is about business. So now for your understanding, what is business? What is the thing you know about business? In general, everyone knows that a business means there will be a purchase or sale of some goods, isn't it? That is only we call it as business. How this business came? How this business came? Every human being is having different needs, isn't it? So every needs need to be satisfied differently. For that they require different products, isn't it? So one may be needing a car, that is my need. Other person may be needing a cycle, so that is his need. So the needs are different, the products are different. So, and not only the products, business not only deals with the product, it also deals with what? Services also. So to satisfy a human need, the product and services was needed. So the person who was dealing with that product or services was called as, or the activity that is dealing with the production or sale or rendering of services was called as business. So they needed the necessity is there to supply goods and services, isn't it? So for that they need to produce or sell, isn't it? What that person need, the individual human being need has to be satisfied by goods and services. So for that there is a need of supplying. To supply a good, we need to produce the good and then we need to sell the good. Are you able to understand the concept? First there is a human need. Okay, well, I need a cycle. We'll take a cycle as an example. So I need a cycle. So my need is there. So if my need has to be satisfied, I have to be supplied with good. I have to be given with the good. It's called the cycle. I have to be given cycle, then only I will be satisfied. So for me to get that cycle, that industry or some person have to produce the cycle and then he have to sell the cycle to me, isn't it? So that is there required for to satisfy a person, human being need. So to supply the goods he require, there should be a production and there should be a sale. So that is why it is called as business. Business is the major activity. Okay, well, it is the major activity, na the biggest activity. There is more. It is the main thing. Okay, well, economic activity. What they have told, it is not only major activity, it is major economic activity. What is economic means? In here, they are meaning economic means as money. Economic means money. So majorly money activity is coming from where? Business only. In the modern society, the money is been flowing only through business. Business, what they are doing? Production and sale. For what? Or they are rendering services. For whom? To the people who require that they are doing, isn't it? So the purpose behind the business activity is what? What is the main purpose? Why should I do a business? The main purpose for what I am doing the business is to earn profit. The earn profit indradha vida earn money. To earn money only they are doing business. So they will earn money only by meeting the requirement of the people. Only when the only when my requirement of cycle is being given to me, I will give money to him. So from that money he is earning money, isn't it? That is what the profit he is earning. No, so if he wants to earn profit, what he have to do? He have to satisfy my need. Or they are telling us what? The demand of goods and services has to be met. Abdin solittu solranga. So they are giving the same thing in different words. Okay, va? So the need has to be satisfied or the demand has to be met. Okay, va? So business is the central thing. So now although the business is main, although everything in the society is running through business, there are some institutions like schools, colleges, hospital, political parties, religious bodies, everything are there, in which business has major influence on our day-to-day life. So apart from business, even these also are there: school, colleges, hospital, political parties and religious places. Religious bodies means what? Temple, church or masood. Okay, that is called as religious places. So all these places, you won't say that I am doing a business called where I am running a school is not a business, college is not a business, hospital is not a business. Business means is to earn profit. All these school, colleges, hospitals and the political parties or the religious activity which we are doing is not business. It is an activity apart from business. Okay, ma? So therefore, now we are going to the concept of business. Now next we are going to read concept, nature and purpose. So first one, we are going to go for concept. What is the concept of business? How did this word business came? Busyness, isn't it? The act of being busy is called business. Okay, wow. Business came from the word busy. Busyness, busyness. I'm always busy, engaged. Busyness, busyness became business. Understood? So the act of being busy is called as business. However, in specific terms, how you will say business, as this is general meaning of business, how this business word came, but specifically what you are doing, occupation in which people regularly engage in the activity related to. So in regular activities, the people is getting engaged. It's like purchase or production, sale of goods or services, all these things will combine together to form a business. In general, it is called as busyness, isn't it? So act of being busy, if you are busy, you are business. Okay, ma? But in specific term, what they are saying, when you are doing in an activity which is consisting of a purchase of goods or production of goods or sale of goods or services, then you are called, then you are termed as business. And not only production and sale alone is not enough, the main view is to earn profit. All that activity should be concentrating on profit only. Okay, well, then only it is called as business. Now in religious place or school or college or hospital, their main motive is not earning profit. Generally the concept is their motive is not to earn profit. Here if you are selling goods or services, if you have the idea of profit, then it is called as business. But all these other institutions are not business institutions, they are charitable institutions. They are we will see about that in the upcoming pages. Now so the activity should consist of what? The activity should consist of purchase or production of goods, or there should be an exchange of goods. Okay, well, exchange or supply of goods or services for what? To satisfy or meet the demand of the people. We already saw this. Now we are dividing the activity into two. How we are dividing this activity into two? One is economic and non-economic. What is economic? Economic means the main motive is money or profit. Non-economic means it is not profit. The main concept is love, sympathy or patriotism. Say for example, if you are running an institution where you are having you are maintaining the kids, okay, to take care of the kids means who are orphaned kids. Okay, you are running an orphanage means, so that activity is not a business. It is a non-economic activity which you have done only by way of love or sympathy, isn't it? So this colleges, schools, hospitals, political parties and religious bodies will come under non-economic activity with love, sympathy and patriotism only they will do. They will not, their main motive is not to earn money. Their only motive is love, sympathy or patriotism. You should understand this concept. So now, economic activities which earn money, we called as what? Economic activities will earn money for their livelihood. Non-economic activity is only by love, sympathy and patriotism. So if a person working as a worker in any institution or a doctor in operating in any clinic, a manager working in the institution, a teacher working in the school, all these are business activity. Because a person working in a factory, so that person will be mainly working for what? Salary. The doctor in a clinic, hospital in general is not for profit motive, but the doctor working there, he needs money, right? So that salary he will be getting. If he is getting a salary or some money for that operation, it is not a non-economic activity, it is an economic activity. So a teacher in a school is an institution in which the main motive is not profit. They are running for a charitable thing, okay? Well, they are running a charitable institution, but the teacher cannot be like that, isn't it? They will be needing money. So the people who are working under that may be an economic activity, but this as a whole, what the institution is giving is only for love and sympathy. You should understand that. So now, on the other hand, so all these person who are working for money, teacher is working for money, factory person is working for money, a doctor is working for money, a manager in the office is working for money. If you are working for money, it is called economic activity. Are you able to understand? If you are working for money, it is called as economic activity. If in your home your mother is working for you, she is cooking, she is doing some activity, isn't it? She is cooking, she is cleaning, she is doing everything. So but is she asking for money for that? No. Why she is doing for love for the family. So that activity is called non-economic activity. So in simple terms, with the one example, same example we'll take, okay? So now mother is doing household work. She is cooking, she is cleaning, she is washing, she is doing every other work, isn't it? So when a mother is doing all the work, she is not expecting money. What she is expecting, what she is doing, she is doing for love for the family, for the children who is hungry, or for the husband who is hungry, she is cooking. So it is because of love. Okay, wow. So if the activity is not for money and if it is by love, it is called as non-economic activity. The same cooking job or cleaning job is done by some other person, okay, wow? Some maid, okay, wow? Who, for what this maid is doing? Is she doing for love and affection of your family? No, the maid is doing the activities, same activity, for what? For money. If the same activity is done for money, it is called as economic activity. The activity done for not money purpose, it is called as non-economic activity. Hope you understood this point. Now in economic activity, we classify that into three: business, profession and employment. So what is business? We will be seeing all that in the upcoming pages, but I'll give you some introduction about it. Business, we will be dealing with procurement or supply of raw materials or supply of goods or selling of goods or rendering of services. But profession, business means, say for example, I'm manufacturing a cycle and I'm selling it. It is a business. What is profession? Profession is, example, I'll give profession. Doctor is a profession. Chartered accountant is a profession, isn't it? So all these are professional thing. Employment means, if I'm working under someone, say for example, working as a maid is also an employment. A worker working in a factory is also an employment. So there is three classification of economic activity. Everyone wants money under this. In business, he wants profit. Profession also, they do some services and they get money in return. We cannot classify as profit. In profession, you cannot classify as profit, because business la what you say, I purchased for 10 rupees, I sold for 15 rupees, so what is my profit? 5 rupees. In services, they are using only knowledge and they are giving only some kind of work they are doing and giving, which is a service. So that is only profession. So for that, how much you spent or how much you bought, you cannot classify. So they are earning money, but you cannot exactly define that as profit. In employment, they are doing some work, they are rendering a service, but they are getting salary instead. Every month they are getting a same fixed amount of money called as salary. That is called as employment. This is the basic understanding about the business. Are you able to understand this? Yes. Next we will be seeing about characteristics of business activities.